We are moving forward to the very first lead talk of the day by Ms. B.V. Prabha, Lead Architect, Electrobit India. So let's welcome her. Over to you now.
Good morning, all. My name is Prabha. I have been working as the lead architect at Electrobit India since 3 years now. I have an overall experience of 21 years in the automotive domain. I welcome you all to this talk on automotive market transformation, resulting security challenges and solution. In this talk, we will have a look at the automotive environment and transformation. We'll also see the new software EE architecture, which is evolving. Increased complexity resulting in vulnerabilities, a holistic security concept, and finally, we will look at a robust end-to-end security solution from Electrobit and Argus together. The automotive market is undergoing transformation and the entire ecosystem is changing. The four main areas of mobility which are seen as disruptive trends are autonomous driving, electrification, connectivity, and shared mobility. In order to develop applications on these main areas of mobility, we need to have a complex infrastructure housed into the vehicle. Also, changes in connectivity are leading to changes in mobility, and we are seeing that shared mobility and connected solutions are gaining momentum. Now, let us look at the market trend. The vehicle, which was all along a means of transport, is now getting transformed into a third living space. McKinsey reports that by 2025, the number of connected cars sold is going to increase annually by fourfold. And by 2025, all the cars that would be released in the market will have connectivity built into it. Now, let us look at how the software is getting transformed. Previously, with the centralized architecture, we were having around 80 ECUs in a mid-segment vehicle or up to 110 ECUs in a high-segment vehicle. The ECUs were connected to sensor at the input and they were driving the actuators at the output. This was a controlled environment and the communication between the ECUs was through serial communication using LIN or CAN or FlexRay protocol. But the applications of mobility require a more sophisticated environment. The consolidation of ECUs has happened, and this has led to the domain control architecture, wherein we will have basically four domains: ADAS, connectivity, infotainment, powertrain, EV, body, and comfort. The cloud connectivity enables the development and deployment of applications on cloud. So some of the examples are a swarm-based architecture and digital twin. We will look a little bit in detail about the domain control architecture. So this is based upon the service-oriented architecture. The advantage of a service-oriented architecture is that the services and the applications can be run on different ECUs, and the services could also be housed on the cloud. And due to seamless connectivity, applications on the vehicle can seamlessly get information from these services, either on the vehicle or on the cloud. In this scenario, we might have applications running on classic AUTOSAR, also interacting with the applications on adaptive AUTOSAR in a hypervised system, running on a POSIX-based operating system like Linux. On the cloud, we will have software services such as over-the-air update services, remote analytics, keyless entry, and so on. Vehicle, which was all along a very safe and secured environment in the past, because of the restricted number of security entry points, has now become more and more vulnerable because of its connectivity to the cloud. Previously, only Bluetooth and OBD dongle were the only two means through which a person could get access to the vehicle network, but Now there are many other functionalities which are added. OEMs are also trying to give more and more features to the end customer. There we have telematics, ECU, infotainment, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, USB, ADAS sensors, acting as attack vectors for the hackers to get into the system. So these attack surfaces, which are nothing but a set of attack vectors, would be used as a platform for the hackers to get into the system and cause an undesirable behavior of the system. Because of the increase in vulnerability, there are also a lot of regulations which have now been brought in. So some of the important regulations are UNECE WP29 warrants cybersecurity for electric vehicles, and ISO 21434 speaks about TARA, which is nothing but the threat analysis and risk assessment which needs to be done for the entire vehicle. Security goals need to be derived, which will have to be implemented on the different ECUs. UNECE R155 mandates a cybersecurity management system, and R156 mandates software update management system. In India, we have AIS 140, which is the automotive industry standard, and they have mandated that for all the public vehicles which are running as fleet, a vehicle tracking device should be installed. So we have seen a lot of crimes, car theft, invasion of privacy, and a compromise to safety happening because of the vulnerabilities. In 2000, just to cite some examples, in 2015, Jeep Cherokee, which was running at 70 km per hour on the road, was hacked by Miller and Belasek, who were sitting inside a laboratory. They were able to gain access to the braking system, acceleration of the car, windshield wipers, to the horn and the infotainment system. Later, of course, Chrysler rectified this error in software and released an update. But this led to huge financial loss for the OEM. Also in 2019, Toyota and Lexus dealership exposed the user database of around 3.1 million users. So these are some of the examples to show how hacking leads to vulnerability. Hacking because of vulnerabilities inside the car leads to huge loss of finances for the OEM. The holistic approach of security is based on the three main pillars, namely prevent, understand, and respond. By prevent, we mean we have to make it as hard as possible for the hacker to get into the system. By understanding, we mean we have to analyze the logs and the events in real time and detect if there are any malicious attacks. And response, we have to mitigate the damage and immunize the fleets as soon as possible through software over the air update. And with these basic three principles of holistic security solution, now let us look at how Electrobit along with Argus provides different solutions in the different layers. So the automotive system security is comprised of five different layers: secure environment, secure extended communication and interface, secure network segmentation, secured onboard communication, and secure platform. First, the secure environment provides two solutions. One is the secure cloud environment, which is used to run the secure cloud services. And next is the Automotive Security Operations Center, or the SOC, as it is generally called as. This understands and responds to attack on vehicles in real time. So the Argus Fleet Protection is the product which is providing the SOC feature. Next is the secure extended communication and interface. Here we have firewall, IDPS, host protection, and secure logging agent as our solutions. The Argus Core ECU and Argus Connected ECU provide control flow integrity. So by control flow integrity, we mean that a hacker will not be able to exploit any vulnerability. And this is done by ensuring that the program does not deviate from the expected execution flow. So this is the mechanism provided from the core ECU and the connected ECU protection. We have ECU firewall just like the way we use firewall on a Windows system. The firewall here also prevents known and unknown attacks from causing further damage to the other ECUs inside the vehicle network. And the security logger helps to collect the events in real time and also collect the vehicle data in real time from the ECUs and store in a secured environment in the cloud, which will be used for further analysis at the security operations center. The network protection. So the network protection is provided by means of IDPS. IDPS acts as the immune system for the connected vehicle. So the intrusion detection and prevention system provides or detects the attack on the CAN network and applications and mitigates it in real time. So this the CAN IDPS is used in the classic AUTOSAR domain, and the Ethernet IDPS is used for the adaptive AUTOSAR domain in case of the domain control architecture. Fingerprinting is done so that it authenticates the message source, and thereby spoofing attack is mitigated. IDPS was all along being tested by penetration testers who used to write test cases and test it. But nowadays, IDPS has gained momentum, and OEMs are actually asking the IDPS solution providers to come up with attack scripts. And these attack scripts from the IDPS vendors would be run on the competitor products to see how good the system is able to immune itself from the attack. Next, we have the secure network segmentation. In the secure network segmentation, we have domain separation of the security zones. The entire vehicle network is segmented into different security areas. It follows an onion. It has an onion security. It is called as the onion security areas, wherein the security areas are nested. And the innermost security area has the highest level of protection. The communication between the security areas is secured by means of gateways. Next, we have the secured onboard communication. In the secured onboard communication, we have the cryptography and encryption algorithms. The cryptographic functions are run in a hardware secure module, and the keys are stored securely in the HSM. Next, we have the secure platform. As part of the secure platform, we have secure boot, secure hardware element, secure update, diagnostics, and separation or isolation as service as solutions. The secure boot, the main purpose of the secure boot is to ensure that the authenticated software from the ECU is always running on the ECU. If any adversary tries to compromise an OS and install a different bootloader, the application which comes up always checks for the authentication. And in this scenario, when a different bootloader is installed, the system will not even boot up. So every time and the first time the vehicle or the system is booted up, this authentication is checked, thereby ensuring that every time the system comes up, the authentication is done. And with respect to the secure network element, usually the flash memories are highly susceptible to attacks. Some of the attacks are done by code injection, by a program flow change, skipping the security checks, side channel attacks for information leak, and so on. So the flash memories need to be securely, need to be secured against these attacks. So this is done by providing a unique device secret as basis of trust. The device authentication ensures that only the ECU is allowed to write into the flash memories. Further, the data that is also stored in the NAND flash is to be encrypted and stored. The secure update provides a secure access between the tester, which is used to update the system or the ECU, and the target ECU. Separation of a secure and non-secure code execution is achieved by two mechanisms. One is the hardware mechanism, and the second one is the software mechanism. In hardware, we have the HSM or SHE in case of microcontrollers, which are used to achieve this. And we have trust zone in case of microprocessors to achieve the same. In software, we have the virtual machine, hypervisor, and containers, which will run on a POSIX-based operating system to achieve the separation or isolation of secure and non-secure execution. On the right-hand side, you can see the crypto driver hardware, which acts as the interface between the base software and the hardware security module. Electrobit provides the firmware for the hardware security module as part of EB Zendure. The hardware security module also contains interfaces for encryption and decryption. Some of the HSM firmwares, which are supported are mentioned: Infineon, SG Chorus, and Travio. In addition to this, we also provide CSM and CRIPE as part of our security offering. CSM provides access the service so that multiple applications can access the security functionality at the same time. It also provides an environment wherein the different security functionality can be given due access and to take care of the encryption and decryption functionality. So the CSM and the CRIPE adhere to AUTOSAR 4.3 standard. In addition to this, we also have software mechanisms for achieving encryption, decryption, and decompression. Yeah, so this is a brief overview of the solutions, security solutions offered by Electrobit and Argus together. If you have any further queries, or if you want to know more about our products, please feel free to reach out to Jay Kishan, who is part of our sales and marketing team. Thank you very much.